All right, next, or now we're going to talk about finding inverses. So we know that for a function f to have an inverse, it needs to be a one-to-one function. So if you have a one-to-one function, we can revert or relate. We can find the related inverse by switch solving and switching, or some texts like to reverse it as switch and solve. But the idea is the same either way. Since one function reverses the other, we need to find the output variable in terms of the input, reversing the relationship. So if you don't have x and y in your expression, if you have it in terms of f of x, you have to replace f of x with y. You need to reverse the relationship. You need to solve the input variable in terms of the output variable. So to do that, we need to solve for the x variable. And then once you've got that, since we're reversing the relationship and inputs become outputs and vice versa, once we have that solved for, we're going to reverse them with step three. We're going to switch x and y. And then you're going to relabel your result as the inversing function f inverse of x. So let's take a look at two examples of how to do this. Okay, so let's grab a pen, and we've got f of x equals 4x minus 1. So y is equal to 4x minus 1. I need both x and y, so I'll replace the output f of x with y because they mean the same thing. Now we need to solve for x. And to do that, we're going to add one to both sides. And you know, I don't like to add one vertically when there's no one to add to it. So kind of tack it up there. Y plus 1 equals 2. Well, that goes to 0. And you're left with 4x. Now to solve for the x, we have to divide everything by 4. And we get x is equal to y plus 1 over 4. Now, we want all of our functions to be in terms of x. So it's our favorite variable. So now we switch x and y. And so we have x plus 1 over 4 equals y. And you label your resulting function as x plus 1 over 4 is the inverse. It reverses the relationship of the related original function of f of x equals 4 minus 1. Now, the next thing it says is we should always make sure that we read all the instructions of a problem to state the domain and the range of each. Well, 4x minus 1, f is 4x minus 1, and that's a line. And if you draw a line real quick, we can see that, sure enough, the domain is going to be all real values, and the range is going to be all real values. So the domain of f is from negative infinity to infinity. The range of f is also going to be from negative infinity to infinity. And if you reverse that relationship, f inverse is x plus 1 over 4. And we ask ourselves a question. Is there anything that could go wrong? There's no division by 0 or roots to worry about negative numbers underneath an even root. So yeah, nothing could go wrong. And so the logic here is that, yeah, definitely. All the domain of f inverse is all real numbers as well, to positive infinity rather. And the range, likewise, is going to be negative infinity to positive infinity. But it's a little hard to see here. This became this. The domain and the range switched roles. And the domain and the range switched roles. It'll be a little more apparent in future examples, because this one is lines. It's not much that can go wrong. Okay, our next example. Good, we've got something where something can go wrong, and I'll let you think about that. So the first thing we need to do is first we just need to get y equals. So y equals 2x plus 1 over x minus 3. Now we need to get the x by itself. And to do that, we have to get, we have to ask what's the problem child. And right now the problem child is that we've got x minus 3 in the basement of a fraction. So we need to multiply by both sides to take care of that. And when you do, sure, the x shows up on the other side, but at least it's not trapped in the denominator anymore, and we can kind of get at it easier. So what do we do next? Well, the next problem is that x minus 3 trapped in the parentheses. So to get it out of the parentheses, I'll just distribute that. I'll get yx minus 3y equals to 2x plus 1. So now I want to get the x's by themselves. I want to solve for x. And the current problem is that I've got one x expression on both sides of the equal sign. So what I'm going to do is we'll move it to the, it doesn't matter whether you move it to the right or to the left. I'm going to move that over to the left. And to do that, I'm going to subtract 2x from both sides. That'll add to 0. And that will leave me with yx minus 2x minus 3y is equal to 1. Now, if I want to get x by itself, the next thing I need to do is I want to move that 3y to the other side, get the y's away from it. I know there's a y in front of the x out front, but we'll worry about him in a minute. So first thing is get anything that doesn't involve x to the other side. Since it's being subtracted, I will add 3y to both sides so that it adds to 0 on the left side. And I will get yx minus 2x equals to 1 plus 3y. Now what? Well, now this one is oftentimes a little bit of a tricky one to see, but what could we do to further kind of isolate or get that x by itself? I can't combine these like terms of yx minus 2x, so we're going to get a little clever here, and I'm going to realize that I could factor out x from both of those expressions and get left with x times the quantity y minus 2. And that has effectively isolated my x. To truly get it by itself, I need to get rid of that y minus 2 expression. And so we'll just divide both sides by y minus 2. And we will get x is equal to 1 plus 3y over y minus 2. We've done it. Now we need to reverse the, switch the variables and label our inverse. So y is equal to f inverse of x. And where there was y, I will now put x's, 1 plus 3x over x minus 2. All right. Now, if you had solved this the other way around, you could get some different signs here. Like if you had moved things to the right instead of the left, it doesn't matter. It will be an equivalent expression by factoring out negative 1 and things. Okay, so next part of the question, domain and range of each. So we will do, in reverse, we will do the inverse function as red. And to go forward from the original function, we'll do that as green. So for the domain of our original function, we have to worry about our bottom, no division by 0. And so we see that our bottom expression, x minus 3, is not allowed to 0. To be 0 leads us to the fact that x is not allowed to be 3. So the domain of our original function is given by all values excluding 3. So negative infinity to 3 unioned with 3 to positive infinity. And to see that, just draw a little number line, put 3 here. You want to round bracket it on either side so you don't hit it, and then slap your infinities where they go, and you got your interval notation. Now, range. That's a bit harder to calculate, and we really haven't talked about how to do that yet. So just stick a pin in the range, because the range of f, we know that inverses reverse each other, is going to be the domain of my inverse. So let's put a pin in that and let's find the domain for my inverse. Well, for my inverse over here, again, we have to worry about no division by 0. And so we see that the bottom of our denominator, x minus 2, is not allowed to be 0. So x is not allowed to be 2. So our domain, because we're solving the domain, the inputs of our inverse function, everything but 2 is going to be negative infinity to 2 unioned with 2 to positive infinity. Okay, so now again, similarly, pause the range thing because we don't know the range. It's hard to find and calculate. But what we do know is that the domain of my original guy, inputs of the original become outputs of the inverse. So the range for my inverse is going to be the domain of my original function, negative infinity to 3 unioned with 3 to infinity. And similarly, the domain of the reversing function is the outputs of the original function. So the range of f is going to be negative infinity to 2 unioned with 2 to positive infinity. All right, we're gonna stick a pin in that right there. And that is a couple examples of finding inverses.